First of all, I would thank Express Computer, Express Group for organizing Technologies of our Northeast and for affording me this great opportunity to be with the leaders of IT from all across Northeast and also from Pan India, the industry leader, the leaders working in the government. And I am very thankful and grateful to this group for this. I must say that I'm really very pleased to be here and to share the story of Information Technology India, you know, which started in the beginning of 90s. And I'm very proud to inform that the growth of IT industry in India started. And at the same point of time, the organization Software Technology Parks of India, which I am heading right now, was created to just facilitate and fuel the growth of IT industry in India. And if you look at the IT profile of India today, it's a very strong industry worldwide, well recognized, and powering the growth of all sorts of R&D happening all across the world. It's a home. India is now home to most of the R&D that is happening worldwide. India has a share of about 56% of the total outsourcing, global outsourcing market in the world. And in year 2017-18, the IT export, the software services export from India has been in the tune of $126 billion. It's a very huge amount of wealth, amount of money. The IT sector in India presently employs around 3.9 million engineers directly, and about three times of indirect job that this sector has created. And that is how you will look at the IT industry as a whole in terms of employment. It employs more than 10 million people all across the country. It's IT industry in India is now serving, is present in almost 80 countries of the world with 200 cities, with 680 delivery centers, global delivery center. So the footprints of IT industry are seen, found all across the world without any exception. And that is how the IT industry in India is the engine of growth, largest urban job creator. And the IT industry over a period of three decades have moved up the value chain. And the IT industry in India is working at the top of the value chain. And the engineers, the experts, working in the industries or doing all sorts of research. If you have heard of the very ambitious research project of Intel about quantum chip development, we'll be very happy to know that it is happening right in Bangalore. And that is how, if you look at India is unquestioned leader in outsourcing in IT services, but there's a lot of question that is being asked as to how we can capitalize the existing infrastructure, the existing talent, and a large base of IT industry in India to catapult, to transform India as a service, from service to a product nation. And that is where all the stakeholders together are working hand in hand, collaborating with each other to make sure that whatever we have achieved till today, whatever foundation we have right now, how we can capitalize on that and transform quickly and position India as a global destination, a product nation over a period of time. And I am very glad, and you must be knowing that India as a whole, all the stakeholders working in collaborative manner or taking initiative to make sure that we capitalize and we convert and transform India from service destination to a product destination. Those who are keenly watching the developments in this sector, they would have noted the recent visit of Honorable Prime Minister of India to Singapore to inaugurate the FinTech Summit that happened in Singapore. And you can clearly see that there is a lot of shift of the entire ecosystem of a startup from all across the world towards India. And that is the kind of strength, that is the kind of potential now India has right now. Talking about the whole initiative, I would say that the challenge right now is the Indian IT profile is limited to few cities of this country. And that is how the whole wealth, whole capacity that has been created is not reaching to the all across the, we are not able to ensure equitable growth, inclusive growth. And even for the jobs, people have to migrate from these locations to metro locations and tier one locations of this country. The challenge is, one, to transform India from a service to a product nation, to disperse the industry at bottom of the value chain initially to the smaller location, tier two and tier three location, and to create large number of talent pool to power the startup ecosystem so that this wave of development is equitable and inclusive, and the wealth and the benefit that is accrued from these kind of initiative is taken to the every person where they are in this country. And for that, I am very happy to inform, and I am sure that you know that in 2015, when Digital India Initiative was taken by Ministry of Electronics and IT under the leadership of Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad ji, which was launched by the Honorable Prime Minister of India, under this initiative, a Northeast BPO promotion scheme was created with 5,000 seats, with 50 crore allocation to start with the purpose of, with an objective to create about 7,500 BPO job in Northeast. And I am very happy that so far we have been able to, and STPI is the nodal agency for implementing this ambitious BPO promotion scheme, primarily to disperse the job, to create the job in Northeast, in BPO sector, in bottom of the value chain. And I am very happy to inform that so far we have been able to allocate about 2,400 seats, where about more than 1,000 seats are operational. And since the jobs are being created over a period of time with passage of time, you would know that about 500 jobs have so far been created. The BPO operations have even started in Majuli Island. This is a very great achievement, and right from Guwahati, Kohima, Imphal, and Majuli. And so many BPOs are going to come, about 28 units have been awarded and have been awarded the work under this scheme. Apart from that, you also know that very recently, I think Compeer has just talked about that Northeast Digital Vision 2022 was launched by the Honorable Minister of Electronics and IT, Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad ji. And this vision was launched to make sure that Northeast is also included in the $1 trillion digital economy that is going to come in India. And that was very necessary. It was also resolved to invest about 10,000 crore Indian rupees in another 4 years' time. And to make sure that digital Northeast is also included and accrues the benefit of the whole movement that is taking shape, Northeast was given a primary focus. And under this focus, I am very proud to inform that Software Technology Parks of India has taken initiative in a very collaborative manner, collaborating with the concerned state governments, Ministry of Development for Northeast Region, Ministry of Electronics and IT. And we are coming up with 8 centers of excellence and 8 innovation zones to make sure not only to tap the local talent, but also to provide the opportunity of the talent pool that is available all across India to come and work for the development of product and application right in Northeast. For that, we are allocating amount of money, and we are bringing a whole ecosystem in collaborative manner. And these areas, we are, like for Guwahati, we have selected agro, IoT in agriculture. Like for Kohima, graphic design. For Shillong, gaming and animation. All sorts of emerging technologies, cutting edge technologies, which are capable of delivering the world class product. Their center of excellence are being created, and the entire ecosystem that is being developed by Software Technology for India being brought here in Northeast, so that Northeast doesn't become a laggard even in upcoming technology. And that is where we are working with the all the stakeholders. The innovation zone is meant for inculcating the culture of innovation, ideating right in these schools, right to the youth of this area, so that the stereotype that people have that the youth of Northeast are powering the, you know, BPO operation all across the country. Not only they continue to power the BPO industry all across the country, they also, you know, come up with the cutting edge technologies and become part of the entire startup journey that is taking shape in India, as I said. With this, I would say that India is, you know, growing beyond imagination with a lot of opportunity, as a, you know, large number of talent pool, as I said, that those who are powering the entire R&D of the world sitting in India. Of course, it is an outsourcing model, but sooner the whole talent pool is going to power another wave, another growth of India, which is going to transform India as a product nation. And I'm sure that the kind of collaborative framework that we have, the kind of hand-holding we have with all the stakeholders working in India, Northeast is also going to be the part of this entire growth journey. And software technology parts of India is working very closely to make sure that this area, this sector, where we are putting our hands, Northeast also included in the entire journey and we take along. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to be with you and for allowing me to share my thoughts with you. Thank you.
Dr. Rai, thank you very, very much for talking.